And thank you, Professor Gamal, for the invitation. And I'm very happy to be with you. And I would be happier to come there, maybe in the maybe soon in the future. The title of my presentation is Key Technologies in Interventional Pulmonology. And it's very important to speak about interventional pulmonology because it's a new subspecialty, a new discipline related to the performance of interventional invasive procedures that require an additional training and expertise beyond that required in a standard pulmonary medicine training program. And it's very interesting what our forefather said one century ago, that in the future, but now is the present, the internist will tap and look and listen on the outside of the chest, and the radiologist will continue to look through the patient, but in many cases, the surgeon, the internist, and the radiologist will ask the bronchoscopist to look inside the patient. And not only to look inside, but also operate inside, like taught us this big man, Professor Dumont, who I was very lucky to meet him. Here is in Florence 3 years ago, and that began the operation with laser and stent. But very important also the introduction of the ultrasound inside the bronchi with Professor Becker, with the radial EBOS, with the Professor Yasufuku, with the linear EBOS, and recently also navigation. I will show you the different tools for navigation, online navigation. And for 10 years, we have also the possibility to cure also the obstructive lung diseases like asthma with thermoplasty and emphysema with valves. This recent introduction of new procedures imposed us to have structured courses and for 12 years, we organized in Italy a master in interventional pulmonology. And we have the need to design the curriculum and what we have to teach to this master. And we published material for teaching in a monography that we published in September 2019. And these are the big chapter of the curriculum for interventional pulmonology. Basic bronchoscopy, endosonography, navigation, transbronchial cryobiopsy, operative bronchoscopy, echography, thoracic ultrasound, pleural procedures like drainage, the ability to manage emergency with bronchoscopy, and the treatment of emphysema and asthma. And there is a chapter in about the bronchoscopy for intensive care unit, because now is more and more used the bronchoscopy also by the anesthesiologists. And it's very important for the pulmonologists to know and to have the the competence in interventional pulmonology, because the pulmonologists have a primary role in the implementation of these advances for identifying high-risk individuals who may benefit from screening, managing pulmonary nodules, detecting screening CT scan, the diagnosis, the staging of lung cancer. And the pulmonologist to manage all this phase of the diagnosis and treatment of lung cancer. And in this, the endosonographic techniques are the most important. The EBOS is a flexible bronchoscope with a convex ultrasound at its tip that enables the sampling of lymph nodes adjacent to the airway under real-time ultrasound guidance. It's a little bigger than a bronchoscope, so it's possible to use it like a bronchoscope or directly through the upper airways or through a tube or through a rigid bronchoscopy. And with a 2.0 or 2.2 working channel, it allows the entry of the aspiration needle. Very important, the staging is to use the EBUS also through the esophagus, the so-called EUS-B-FNA. And with the two procedures, it's possible to have a medical mediastinoscopy because it's possible to reach the majority of the lymph nodes of healer and the mediastinum. The surgeon recognized this and the point that they recognized the mediastinoscopy now is an obsolete procedure and reserved only for very, very few situations. And with EBOS, it's possible to reach also the left adrenal gland. And you can see here the shape of the left adrenal gland, normal, seagull. This is a metastasis of left adrenal gland. It's very important in the general evaluation of a patient with a suspected metastasis of left adrenal gland. And it's possible also to reach intrapulmonary tumors when are adjacent to esophagus or to trachea or bronchi. In our operation suite, we have also a microscopy, very important for the application of ROES, or rapid on-site evaluation, because it permits fewer number of passes of the EBUS TBNA and allow a requirement of additional bronchoscopy procedures and improve the efficiency of the procedures with 3 minutes of procedure. It's very important also the specimen management in our operating suite, because after the acquisition of a specimen, we have to perform the slides, one for the rapid onset evaluation and one for the laboratory or more for the laboratory, but also the cell block. And we use a lot of the clot core, that is made, putting the material on the glass slide, and especially when it's very abundant and bloody, and left there coagulating for some minutes, and then transferred to a 10% formalin. It's very easy for the pathologist to evaluate this kind of sample, like a biopsy. Because we know that comparing with the past, we need more and more material, better. The pathologist wants more and more material for the diagnosis, not only for the diagnosis, but where we need also immunocytology, immunohistology, but also for other markers like PD-L1 for immunotherapy, and the markers of mutation for biologic treatment. And help from new procedures come from the EBUS elastography imaging. When in the EBUS is to also the strain elastography, when it's blue, for example, is malignant, the lymph node. When it's green, is more probable that this lymph node was benign. And it's possible also to find the best part of the lymph node to have the specimen. And the conclusion of this multicentric study are that strain elastography helps predict malignant lymph node involvement in patients with lung cancer. And the addition of ultrasound strain elastography to EBUS short exercise and MPET avidity improves this stratification for malignancy. And another help comes from the new needle for histology, and better from the mini forceps for histology. But maybe in the future will give us an help for the diagnosis, also for the lymphoma. Another big chapter is the navigation for peripheral pulmonary lesions. Because we know that when, especially when the pulmonary nodule is small, or is in periphery, like for example in the Nelson study, you can see that in this study was the nodules are most in the periphery, so very difficult to diagnose. And also very difficult when the nodule is some solid or ground glass. So we need to have the confirm, the histologic confirmation, because we know that tissue is the issue with the nodules, and that pulmonary nodules are malignant until proven benign. For this, we have many procedures, but the less sensitive is the washing, only 9%. For this, we say that in every bronchoscopy suite, we need the systems for guide to reach these lesions. And the modern bronchoscopy suite need more and more instrument, like here. and this in the left is our old bronchoscopy suite. Because we know that we have also the transthoracic needle aspiration, but we know also that the complications are very high with this approach. The diagnostic yield is bigger than the transbronchial, 93% compared to 75%, but we know also that the pneumothorax is very frequent, more or less 20% of procedure, and also bleeding is frequent. For this reason, we prefer transbronchial biopsy, but also the efficacy of a transbronchial biopsy depends on nodule size, the location, the relationship to the patient airway, the so-called bronchus sign, the risk of complication, the available expertise of the operator. The ideal navigation tool should be accurate, accessibility, low complication rate, easy to learn and use, with a minimal impact on work flow. Many procedures are very, very time consuming. Versatility, able to use in multiple settings, no special anesthesia needs, and inexpensive. The most popular is the fluoroscopy, guided TBNA, TBB, that is very useful when the lesion is big, more than 2 centimeters, and visible in the fluoroscopy and with the bronchus sign, like in this case. And as you can see, it's very easy to reach the lesion and take biopsy or TBNA. And when the lesion is very far in periphery, we have the possibility now to use also the ultra-thin bronchoscopy with a channel, operative channel of 1.7 millimeter that permit also the passage of a mini probe. Another tool very important and very popular is now the radial EBOS that is recommended also by the ACCP guidelines. And with the sensitivity of 67%, but with a bigger sensitivity in the when the mini probe is inside within the lesion, and less sensitive when it's adjacent to the lesion, 63% against 61%. Not only radial EBOS, but also navigation systems are recommended by the guidelines. At the moment, we have three kinds of navigator. The one is a virtual bronchoscopy, virtual navigator, and two are electromagnetic navigators. The bronchus length point compare the position of the bronchoscope inside the airways with the virtual reconstruction and guide the operator to the lesion. And the efficacy in many studies that you can see is high, 73%, so not bad. And combined with the that navigator is the transparenchymal nodule access that permit to reach lesions when there is not the bronchus sign. The electromagnetic navigators are the Veran. The most modern is Veran that have less influence with the expiratory movement, and the characteristics that is always on instrumentation. Steerable, every accessory, forceps, brushes, have a deep tracheal steerable working, steerable guide. And it's possible also with the Veran to perform a transthoracic biopsy. Not the CT scan guided, but guided by this system, by the navigator. The other is, and is most, is oldest, but very diffuse and popular worldwide, is the superdimension logic system that use a deep tracheal locatable guide through a catheter system, but you have to take out the guide and put in another moment, in a second moment, the biopsies, the forceps and the needles. So it's more time consuming comparing to the Veran, but the you can see it's very impressive the performance of this procedure. This is the reconstruction of the airways with the lesion, and before the beginning of the procedure you had to map and to combine the magnetic guide with the system. Then you have to take out and you have to guide the guide to the lesion, and then enter with the accessories like forceps. This is a cartoon. you can see the catheter inside the lesion, and here the tBNA or biopsies. It's a virtual reconstruction, so have some margin of error. And it's possible also to put the markers for the stereotactic for radiotherapy. And the yield is similar to the other navigator is 70-75. now to improve the yield, the efficacy of the electromagnetic navigation, there is the proposal to use the augmented fluoroscopy that we can see, we will see in the near future. And another system, very interesting system, is this iNode of Boston Scientific that is a needle with electromagnetic needle that permit to enter directly inside the lesion, passing through the operative channel of the bronchoscope. The last system proposed to have a more precise position of the bronchoscope and the forceps is the combing guided TBB. I have taken this video, these images from a visit that I did in Hong Kong to the Professor Calvin Ng, and because he performed this system not only for the diagnosis but also for the treatment of the nodules. For this reason, you have to be very, very precise. And here you can see the combination of combing and electromagnetic navigation permit to improve the diagnostic yield to 83%, so higher than the navigation, only the navigation. And the future will be this, the robotics. And it's not the future, but it's the present. There are few systems, but there is also a study, the benefit study, that demonstrated that lesion localization success is higher than the navigation, 96%, with a low rate of complication as a pneumothorax. This is a figure of the different systems with accuracy, complication, and learning curve that increase from EBUS, radial EBUS to COMBIN, for example, and other characteristics. Very interesting is the possibility to diagnose and treat the nodule. The Professor Calving is a presentation to our master in Florence this year, and he demonstrated a good, a very, very good success combining electromagnetic navigation, a microwave ablation technology inside an hybrid operating room. Last is a procedure that the position the valves that you know that are used for the emphysema, but we demonstrated the possibility to treat with this system also the multi-drug resistant TB and typical mycobacteriosis with the cavities. We published this a case series in the Journal of Respiration in 2016, and then we have other procedures in our center. We hypothesized that these valves could be an effective complementary treatment in the management of these pathologies. And in our series of seven cases, we demonstrated that this is safe with fewer side effects. We obtained a microbiological success in all the patients, only some failures in healing cavities, and the potential useful in severe respiratory failure for lung destruction. Success obtained in patient more when we obtain lobar atelectasis, and it's very interesting. The conclusion of the editorial of our publication that may present a new complementary approach to treat otherwise incurable TB in patients who are not candidates for surgical intervention. Last is the use of technologies for the training. This is what we use for you can see here the third master, but now we are at the 12th master. And we use a lot of these tools for simulation to improve the dexterity, to improve the skill of the participants of the master. And for this reason, we organized a workshop 2 years ago in Venice, inviting many experts from also from South America, China, and United States, and so on, to design a common curriculum and common model for training interventional pulmonology. And this is the last master that we organized, 12th, the next will be 13th. And I hope in the future maybe to have some Egyptians, some young Egyptians in our master. Looking forward to see you in presence again. I remember these moments in your city, and I hope to see you soon. Thank you very much for your attention.